Brother Etrus of the Imperial Fists is a dour and stoic warrior. He revels in the destruction caused by his multi-barreled assault cannon as he guns down hordes of brutal orcs in the defence of shield generator Gamma 9. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint Brother Etrus up to battle-ready standard. We're going to use tips and techniques to get him done in no time at all, so you can involve him in your games of Space Marine Adventures Rise of the Orcs. Now, to prepare our model for painting, we've already undercoated him here with Corax White spray. But don't worry if you haven't got a can of Corax White to hand, you can always use a pot of Corax White and a brush instead. Once the undercoat is dry, it's time to move on, and the first paint we're going to be using here is Avalon Sunset to apply that really famous Imperial Fists yellow armour. Grab your medium base brush and let's get to it. So first of all, let's get some paint from the pot and apply it to our palette like so. When applying a base coat, add a little bit of water from your water pot here to help thin down the paint, which means it will go onto the model a little more smoothly. Then, onto the miniature. Here, we're going to be applying Avalon Sunset all over Brother Etrus' armour. You can be quite messy here. Don't worry if you hit other parts of the model, it's okay. Just make sure you're getting a nice even coat of Avalon Sunset all over the armour. Take your time, get it right, be as neat as you possibly can, but again, don't worry if you make a mistake. We're going to cover the other parts of the model later on. There we go, that's the yellow base coat applied to Brother Etrus. Up next, let's have a look at shading that armour. Right now it's a bit of a big yellow block and we want to try and break that up. And to do this, we're going to use a contrast paint, Dark Oath Flesh, and paint it into the recesses in between the armour panels. This is quite small detail, so for this we're using our small airbrush. Let's take some paint from the pot like so and add it to our palette here. Now we're not going to thin this down with water, but we are going to make sure we're not overloading our brush with too much paint. We're also going to make sure our brush is nice and thin as we're painting very small detail. There we go, perfect. Then, onto our Space Marine. Here, we're going to be painting this into the recesses in between all of the armour panels. So wherever there's a recess in the yellow armour, I'm just going to very carefully paint it in like so with a small brush. Now this is going to take some time, but it's really worth taking the time to be as neat as you possibly can. Do this all over the entire model, and once it's done, you'll really see a difference. There we go, that's the line shade done all over Brother Etrus' armour. Alright, up next let's have a look at painting his white veteran's helmet. Now here we're going to be painting over the Corax White undercoat, but if at this point you've accidentally made a mistake and painted the helmet with anything else, go back now and touch up that helmet with Corax White paint out of a pot. We want to make sure we've got a nice smooth white surface we're working over. The paint we're going to use here is Apothecary White, a contrast paint, and we're going to thin it down with a touch of contrast medium. Here's how we're going to do it. First of all, take your medium shade brush and add some contrast medium to your palette. We'll take one brushful here and put it onto our palette like so. We're going to clean off our brush to make sure there's no medium left on it at all. Bit of tissue paper there. Then one brushful of Apothecary White gets added onto the palette like so. A bit more, there we go, touch more, there we go. Then we've got a nice thin Apothecary White to work with. Then onto the miniature. Here we're going to work this onto the helmet of Brother Etrus like so. Just very carefully working it across all the white helmet like this. Just making sure it's nice and smooth as it's being applied. As it's drying, go back and just make sure it's not pooling in any of the recesses. We don't want it to be gathering too much in any of the deeper places. We want a nice smooth coat here of Apothecary White. There we go, that's his helmet done. Let's add some more details to the miniature now. We'll start off by painting the joints in between Brother Etrus's Terminator armour with Eschen Grey. Then we'll paint the silver parts of the model with Lead Belcher. We'll paint the Aquila on his chest with Evil Sun Scarlet, and finally we'll paint the Marksman's Honour on his gun with Runelord Brass. Once those are done, we'll add Basilicon and Grey over all of them to shade them down. First of all, that base coat of Eschen Grey on the joints in between his Terminator armour. For this, we're using our small layer brush, as the details are really small. Let's take some paint from the pot here, add it to our palette like so. Now here we're going to add a touch of water, just to help thin the paint down so it goes on a bit smoother. Bingo. Also make sure we've got a nice smooth brush, and a nice pointer there as well. There we go. So, onto the miniature. Here, we're painting the Eschen Grey into the joints in between the Terminator armour. So, going around the model like so, just very carefully painting these joints like so. There's joints on the legs, and the arms, and on the hips too, so make sure you get them all. Next up, we're painting Lead Belcher onto the silver parts of the miniature. So this is all the metal, such as all the metal on the gun. We've also got lots of sigils and markings all over the miniature. And don't forget the fingers of his power fist here as well. Also the vents on the back of the Terminator too, and these wires. If you're a bit confused about which parts of the model want to be metal, have a really good look at the pictures in the Space Marine Adventures Rise of the Orcs rulebook. Next up, we'll paint the Aquila on his chest with Evil Sun Scarlet. Again, here we're using a small airbrush, so we have lots of control. Next up, we're picking out this marksman honour. This is the bullet hanging down from the assault cannon with Rune Lord Brass. We're also going to paint the ammunition in the ammunition hopper of the assault cannon with the same colour. Next up, take a medium layer brush and add Basilicanum Grey contrast paint over all of the areas we've just painted. So that's the metal, the red, the Eschen Grey and the brass. All those areas, just hit it with a Basilicanum Grey contrast paint. There we go, that's the Basilicanum Grey dry on all those areas, and you can see it's added loads of cool contrast and shade. Up next, let's have a look at painting the casing on Brother Etrus' massive assault cannon. For this, we're going to be using a Baden Black and our medium layer brush. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Now we're going to be adding a touch of water here just to help it go onto the model nice and smoothly. There we go, nice pointy brush too, and onto the miniature. Here, we're just going to be picking out the assault cannon casing like so. Just being really careful not to hit the metal areas if you possibly can, but again, don't worry if you make a mistake. You can always go back with lead belcher and correct that. While we have the Baden Black open as well, we're also going to pick out this small armour plate in his shoulder here as well, to be very careful not to hit the yellow parts. There we go, that's the black painted in. Up next, let's have a look at painting some more details. Here we're going to paint the parchment of the Purity Seals and the Crux Terminatus on his shoulder with Rakarth flesh. Once that's done, we'll apply contrast paint Skeleton Horde over the top. And then we'll pick out the wax of the Purity Seals with Barrocknar Burgundy. For all of these, we're using our small layer brush. Let's take some Rakarth flesh from the pot here and onto our palette. And again, a touch of water, just a little bit to help smooth that paint down. Bingo. Then onto the miniature. Here, we're painting the Purity Seals on his leg and under his waist as well. So just picking out the parchment like so. Also pick out these ones here. And don't forget to paint the entire Crux Terminatus on his shoulder pad as well. Next up, it's a layer of Skeleton Horde contrast paint over all those areas. So just onto the Purity Seals here, and also don't forget onto the Crux Terminatus too. We want a nice even coat here with the contrast paint, so making sure we're giving a nice smooth coat, and once it's painted, don't go back to it. Next up, we're picking out the wax of the Purity Seals with a touch of Barrocknar Burgundy. Again, we're using a small airbrush here and being super careful not to hit any other areas around it. There we go, that's the parchment and the shoulder pad complete. The only details left to paint on Brother Etrus are the lenses and gems on the miniature, and we're going to paint these the same way. We'll start off with a base coat of grey sear, and over the top of that a contrast paint, warp lightning will be applied to give a really cool glow effect. Let's start off with that base coat of grey sear, and for this we're using our small layer brush, as these details are super fine. Let's take some paint from the pot, and again onto our palette, just like this, just a little bit of paint, not too much, a touch of water here as well to help thin it down, perfect. Then onto our miniature. Here we're picking out all the lenses and gems on the model, so watch out for these lenses and bits and pieces like this here on the waist, the lenses over here on top, the eye of the Space Marine as well, also any other lenses around the miniature too. Then over the top of this we're painting Warp Lightning contrast paint to give a really cool glow effect to those lenses and jewels. And with that, Brother Etrus himself is painted. But of course, that's not the entire model done. Now I'm going to paint the base as well. And for this, we'll start off by base coating the entire base with Mournfang Brown. We'll pick out the metal bits with Lead Belcher, pick out the bullet casings with Runelord Brass, the big stone he stood on in Grey Seer, and once that's done, we'll wash Agrax Earthshade over the entire base to help shade it down. First of all, it's that base coat of Mournfang Brown. For this, we're using our small base brush. So as always, let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Just a touch of water here to thin it down. Bingo. Then onto the miniature. Here we're carefully painting the entire base, all of it, with Mournfang Brown. Don't worry about hitting details that aren't going to be brown. We're going to go over those later on. But do worry about hitting the model's feet. So be really careful around Etrus's feet to make sure you don't hit them. Next up, we're grabbing our small layer brush again and picking out the metal parts. So there's a grill going on the floor here, which continues over here. Also, he's staying on a metal plate here as well. Next up, we're picking out those bullet casings on the ground with Runelord Brass. Next up, we've got a medium layer brush and some grey sear. And we're very carefully picking out this massive rock Brother Etrus has stood on. Be super careful here not to hit any of the bullet casings or indeed Brother Etrus's feet. You may also find you need a couple of coats to get a nice solid colour of grey sear, so let the first one dry, then apply a second coat afterwards. Next up, load up a medium shade brush with some Agrax Earthshade and apply it all over the base. Literally everywhere, so over the stone, the ground, the metal, the bullet casings, everywhere. On a nice liberal coat of this, and allow about 30 minutes for it to fully dry. Once it has, we'll paint the rim of the base with Abaddon Black. And there we go, with the base done, Brother Etrus is ready to defend Shield Generator Gamma 9 against the hordes of orcs. And that's how you can paint Brother Etrus of the Imperial Fists up to battle-ready standard in no time at all. A couple of things to remember here. First of all, when you're applying your base coats, always thin your paints down. That will help the paints go onto the model a lot more smoothly. Next up, when you're applying all your paints, try and be as neat as you possibly can. But don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back later and correct them. Hope you enjoyed the video. Happy painting.